10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Ayy. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my dance. I was top. They just watched. Had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I gold it again and again. Who is the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the Steel City at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks. Here we go from Heinz Field as Chris Boswell tees it up and boots it away. Taken in the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
First and 10 and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
Carson, the ball carrier.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking. And that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
And this will be a Seahawks first down as the tackle made at about the 43-yard line.
The tackle made.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. Forced out to his left. He'll try and run it. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
You know, I don't think this is the last time we'll see that in this game. This guy has mobility, and they want to use his legs in the game plan. So there will be designed runs as well as his scrambles.
On second down. It's Carson, and he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. A three-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard.
And it's third down.
Here's Carson. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. He's 10 yards and a Seattle first down.
It's a gain of 10. First down, Seattle.
Now they'll throw it with Wilson. And this is caught at the 8. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3.
First and
it's a gain of 34. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door. First and goal. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It's a loss of four on the first down play.
So often you hear that pep talks don't really work in the heat of the battle, but collectively, this defense has to say to each other, we've been on our heels this whole first drive. This is where we need to dig in. And they got a nice stop right there for a loss on first and goal.
Well, they'll try the sweep. It's Lockett with it. Trying to turn the corner, but they string him out and stop him at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. Can this defense get the stop on the opening drive? Here's third and goal. From the shotgun, Wilson. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the seven. That's Cameron Hayward who got in there to take him down.
That's quite a stand there defensively. A huge sack on third down, and that's going to force him into a field goal attempt.
Score after one on EA Sports.
No score.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. Open is Olsen, he's got it. Touchdown, Seahawks.
Olsen. Touchdown, Seattle.
A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks take the ball down the field and score on the opening drive. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead.
Seahawks 7, Steelers nothing. Jason Myers to kick off.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Off the play fake, he'll set up to throw it. Eluding the pressure right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Play fake to Connor. Now Roethlisberger. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. It's caught inside the 25. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Juju Smith-Schuster. 75 yards. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Seahawks take over first and 10.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains. Now a throw for the left sideline, and he's got it. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
First down, Seahawks.
He hits his target, Lockett. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
First down, Seattle.
Wilson will throw again. Flushed out right. And out, and he is in for the Seattle touchdown.
Touchdown.
A 12-yard touchdown run. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Off the play fake. Here's Roethlisberger. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Quandre Diggs there defensively.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched it move for move and knocked it away.
He dumps this off underneath to McFarland. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13. And he'll take this forward for about five as we have come upon the two-minute warning. 5 yards is the tally on first down. It brings up second and five. They go play action with Roethlisberger. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. Play action. It's Roethlisberger. He's going to loft one deep left side. And this is caught at the 20. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Deontay Johnson, 59 yards. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And he's able to put it through.
That ties the game at 14.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. There have been points on the board. We just saw back-to-back touchdown drives. I love it. I'm high-fiving our statistician, Christian McLeod, and you're angry. You're a defensive guy.
If you met one of my defensive...
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Russell Wilson with two first-half touchdown passes. And the Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown. And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key is calling it in the right situation, knowing when it exists to go to it. They did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like, man, can you have strung that out just a few plays? Give us a break. Back out there.
Hey, man, give that water break and get on out there and play.
Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A gain of 32 that time. Being chased out left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wise move there looked like nobody open. Now second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. It actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Jalen Samuels.
And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 5 yards. Now it's third and five.
Brings up third and
on third down, here's Samuels. And a good job on the tackle there as they get him down shy of the first on the 35-yard stripe. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. They'll run for it with Samuels. And he is not going anywhere. They stop it for no gain. He needed two. He barely got back to the line of scrimmage. And the Seahawks are going to take over the football. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen. And this will be caught at the 30. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Making a hat trick for Russell Wilson. Three touchdown passes now. And the Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14.
28, Steelers 14.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Fielded right around the 8. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 13-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down, it caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on, and it's second down. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Final play of the half. It's Roethlisberger. They'll roll him out right. Oh, now he'll try and chuck it deep left side. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon.
Kickoff for Seattle.
The Steelers going to get the football first here, trailing on the scoreboard as we are back underway on EA Sports. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. They go play action now. Roethlisberger, he'll buy some time right. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25.
2nd and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Play action. Now Roethlisberger. It got his man complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
1st and 10 at the 40.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. thrown across his body, and it's intercepted.
Jordan Brooks with it.
And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man. And he'd be able to take a few extra chances.
And the defense loses him. It's complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one goes for 30 yards. From the gun, it's Wilson. Flush to his right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. T.J. Watt. He's the one who runs him down. And my goodness, that is just a disastrous loss for this offense. Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. A breakdown defensively there as the scramble is going to set him up with a much more manageable third down.
But it's third down.
Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Russell Wilson now with four touchdown passes on the afternoon. And they see, oh, it's a fake. They'll try and throw for it.
Partner, they had a good lead as they went in at the half, and they came out here in the second half and found a way to extend it. I love their consistency. Don't worry about what they said at halftime. This seemed like a team that was ready to play 60 minutes. And while this game is far from over, I love their approach.
Wilson now operating from the gun. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's Devin Bush, the linebacker, who picks it. He's at the 50. 30. 20. 10, 5, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way.
Steelers 16.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Yeah, turn the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Complete to Juju Smith-Schuster.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Trying to get the first with Samuels. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Pittsburgh getting 16 yards there and also a first down. Here's Samuels. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Jalen Samuels, 51 yards. And the Steelers are able to cut into that deficit.
Well, I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
34, Steelers 22.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
coming to the line here to begin their next drive. The Seahawks offense, they've got to right the ship. They had a great first half, but the lead has really gone down. Now, you know, you always talk about the adjustment to the adjustment. They've got to adjust right here.
And I think a lot of it is just mentally. Get back to doing what you were doing well in the beginning of the game, but a lot of that is playing with that emotion and that sense of pride and fire that sometimes goes away a little bit when you build up a lead. You think you've got it going, and you also think, at any moment, I can go ahead and go back to the way it was before. You and I both know it's not that.
End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Seahawks add on to their lead. Oh, and now they're going to fake it.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that
it's a wobbler, and it's intercepted. It's a foot race. He's at the 30. And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way.
Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. From the 10. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. They'll start the drive with Samuels. And he'll take this one for about four up to the 40. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
Dunlap on the tackle.
From the 40 now on second down, Roethlisberger setting up the screen. This is Samuels. Back now in Pittsburgh. It's the Steelers with the football, but trailing here as we get going in quarter number four. And the Steelers on third down. They've been near perfect, 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and four. First carry for James Conner. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Call it a gain of four, and it'll bring up fourth down.
It's fourth down.
They'll run for it with Conner. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Steps away. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away, incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. On first down, it's Samuels. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Loss of a yard. Brings up
on second and 11 now. Roethlisberger hitting Juju on the slant. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off down near the 5. He's at the 50. He's at the 40. The 20. 10. 5. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With Jason emphasis, interception, return for touchdown.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. It's a wobbler, and it's intercepted. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
And this doesn't work. The Steelers recover it. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more.
And Big Ben intercepted a third time. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And the return comes to a halt.
Diving in his pool.